Hi friends, it's Shani, Certified Feline Training and Behavior Specialist with Wild at Heart. And is your cat afraid of strangers? Listen, I so feel you on this because my cat is notoriously afraid of strangers. And during COVID, we had no company. So when friends started visiting again, she just was really scared. Here are some tips to help your cat adjust to new people coming to your home. First, your cat should have a safe room. And this room should have everything that they need. Food, water, litter boxes, toys, enrichment items, and most importantly, an appropriate hide place that makes them feel very safe. This room should not be a room that the strangers or visitors are gonna have to go in and out of. Some people are into this idea of tough love, and they will lock their cat out of their safe area and force them into areas with people that they are fearful of. This will not work. It will backfire. You absolutely should provide your cat a safe space, and you should never lock them out of it. One thing that we do in our house is we tell anyone that's coming over to just walk through the door, because anyone who knocks or rings the doorbell, it's very triggering for my cat. So just remove that trigger so we can really start with positivity. You can play soft music or a movie or TV show to drown out possible noise that your visitors may make. I watch Seinfeld all the time, and I know my cat associates Seinfeld with me. So that's a show that I will often play if I'm feeling like I either need to drown out some noise or I'm feeling that she is experiencing maybe a little bit more stress or fear. There's also these music boxes that are scientifically proven to reduce stress in cats. They are called Pet Acoustics. You can buy it directly from their website or even on Amazon.
You can also get them on Chewy.com.
Either right before people arrive or as they arrive, you should be providing your cat with a high-value treat or wet food. This treat or wet food needs to be something that is super special. It can't be their everyday treat and their everyday wet food. The value of the wet food needs to match the request that we are asking of our cat. In these first stages, when people start to come over, you want to provide that treat or wet food throughout the visit. We're not expecting anything else from our cat. We're simply letting them know when people come over, you get something super awesome. Just so you know, playtime works as well. If play is super rewarding and reinforcing for your cat, use that either instead of treats or food or in addition to. Because play is a natural stress reducer. And if your cat feels stressed with strangers, playtime is going to naturally reduce that anxiety and stress. The hope is that as you do this, every time you have company, you're providing super amazing, rewarding, and reinforcing items, your cat eventually will venture out and see what's doing out there. And if they do venture out on their own, amazing. Instruct your guests to ignore your cat. Tell them, don't look at the cat, don't approach the cat, don't try to touch the cat. Now, I know this sounds a little bit crazy, but it works. Science tells us that cats love control and they love consent. They need to have autonomy over their own bodies. And when we allow them to approach us versus us approaching them, they are more likely to trust us. And when they do approach us, those interactions last much longer versus if we start the interaction. Your guests should have access to those treats and that wet food. So if your cat approaches them, they can immediately give them the treat or the wet food, and that's it. No expectations, no touching. Also really good to get down to the cat's level. Have your guests sit on the ground. Have those treats in hand. We don't want people getting up to go get the treat or the wet food. If the cat approaches you, it's probably going to scare them away. Sometimes cats just want to sniff us. Allow them to sniff you, sniff your guests, and allow them to walk away. Again, no touching and no staring. And don't forget about playtime. Give your guests super enticing wand toys. See if your cat wants to engage with play with your guests, which again is a natural stress reducer. I did this with our cat, and after several visits, she started coming out of her safe room, and I just told everybody, don't look at her, don't approach her, don't try to touch her. Not only did she start approaching people, she actually jumped onto the bench, and then she jumped onto the table. Then she started approaching people, and she started letting people touch her. And for Sweet Pea, that's a big deal. If your cat just plain refuses to leave their safe room, in my opinion, that's okay. You can still pair visitors coming over with the high value treat or wet food. If you want to take them a step further, for whatever reason, you can have your guests go into the safe room and give your cat the high value treat or wet food and then leave the room. Honestly, I don't think there's anything wrong with cats hiding from strangers if they feel safe and comfortable in that safe room. Now, if they're in the safe room and they feel anxious or afraid and they are stressed out, then yes, we should work on this counter conditioning and desensitization. The biggest component here, if you haven't guessed, is the reinforcement. We need to teach cats that every time this event happens, every time you have guests, it used to be scary for them, and now you're teaching them every time we have guests, you get this super high value treat or wet food or toy. I've been so proud of Sweet Pea and how far she's come. She has met so many people throughout her life. I've had so many people over into my home. This is the first time that she has been so social, and it is because of the techniques I just talked about.
I mean, look at her, y'all.